How's everybody doing today?
Okay.
That last little bit you just saw there, I can't find my phone, and I didn't turn my ringer off. So Ben just called my phone, and apparently I did turn my ringer off. So there we go. So because I didn't want to be that guy that had his ringer on, right? So before we get started, as usual, there is a lot. There's going to be a lot of firsts today. There's a lot going on with Jazz Outreach Initiative and Las Vegas Youth Jazz Orchestra. Before we actually get to the music today, I want to ask our executive director, Donnie Thompson, to come up here. Donnie? Like to do is we love to do the classics, and I can't think of a better way to start off on the jazz afternoon than with Count Basie's Cue.
Thank you.
if you do the program, you're going to see at least one count basis doing on it.
I can't think of a better way to learn jazz and count basis.
So as our executive director mentioned earlier, we are fortunate to partner with NSA on this concert. And at this time, I would like to ask the NSA Combo to join us, and I would like to turn the stage over to the NSA Combo and their director, Charles McNeil.
Also by Kenny Dorn. Thank you.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you, Mike. A lot of time in jazz education, spends time teaching the kids how to play, but leading a band, being a front person, and engaging with the audience is just as important. So, with that being said, I'm going to let Sohan say goodbye to you wonderful folks, and thank you for showing up. Once again, let's hear it from the students of jazz at Woody Salem. And we were talking about, a lot of this is it's actually, these students, they learn a lot through jazz. They learn about cooperation, they learn about how to interact with each other. We here at Georgia say we love to connect the language of music with the language of life. And you watch that process happen up here as they were talking about, let's do this tune, I'm going to do this, and you saw them work it out through the music. And that's what's so special about watching the students and watching that happen as we go. So we have a lot of firsts in LBYJ of this semester. And the first is we actually started combo classes. Now, we have two combos at WYJO, and the first one that you're going to hear from today, and I made the program, I can't remember who it is. All right, so the first combo you're going to have here today is actually led by my mentor, Eddie Rich, who is not here today. He is in Spain, lucky him. So, but this combo we call the Joy Jazz Messengers. All right, and you know the Jazz Messengers are very famous. Group, and so we're going to have two selections for you today. Oh no, wait a minute, am I wrong? Yeah, I'm wrong. Right. Okay, I'll repeat all that here in two songs. The first group up today is the Joy Jazz Crusaders, and their mentor is in Europe, that is Rachel Aircraft. So I have asked my friend who comes in and helps for the kids. She does a lot for Las Vegas Youth Jazz Orchestra, for the Joy Jazz Orchestra, and now for the combos, I've asked Etsy from Mater to sing with me today. The first tune that we're going to play for you is a selection by Horace Silver. This is called the Joy Grind. Thank you.
Thank you.
George Eric Fisher, who has been performing on alto saxophone. Jay Cobb on trombone. Samir Nari on tenor sax. Matt Solomon on drums. And once again, thank you, Reverend Colonel Mater, for setting in. So we were really fortunate this semester to do another aspect of playing in a big band. We're very blessed to have a vocalist. And at this time, I would like to invite Amelia Morrow to come to the stage. Selections for you. The first one is Autumn Leaves.
Thank you.
How about you? You heard from Paul Bearden on alto saxophone? Dr. Luigi on trumpet? Gino Motto on tenor saxophone? Deanna Christensen on trumpet? Ben Bernstein on bass? I always enjoyed back going between the two combo classes is that these arrangements are actually the result of what happens throughout the semester during the class. And Rachel and Eddie would take the ideas that the students had and they would slowly morph into an arrangement. And one of the things that you're going to see in the next song, if I'm right, correct me if I'm wrong, the clapping didn't happen until the recording, right? He came in before the recording, or the rehearsal before the recording, and said, I got an idea for the way this starts. And so even all the way up to the recording, this whole thing was still taking place. And it's just wonderful to watch the creative process and see the input from all the students. So the Joy Jazz Messengers will be doing their last tune today, and this is Caravan by Juan Tizol and Duke Ellington.
Thank you.
Can you hear from that team? You heard Matt Ellis from trombone. Gina Morrow on center sax. Sam Fuller on trombone. Christopher Garfield on piano. You saw me frantically counting and trying to cue things, and the students corrected me. So, thank you very much. So, as I told you earlier, we have a lot of firsts happening today, so I need to get set for this because I have a lot of things to talk about that I can't remember. So today is a collaboration between Jazz Outreach Initiative and the LBYJO and the Nevada School of the Arts. You know, recently we had our home here, and but our roots with the Nevada School of the Arts go much deeper than just the last 4 or 5 years, and they go, you know, we have a connection with the NSA between the members that are in Jazz Outreach Initiative and people that used to run NSA, what, about 25, 30 years ago. Our founder, Kenny Rampton, came through NSA. I actually attended NSA. And the connection there was between our teacher, Walter Blanton. I'm sure some of you know that name, Walt. Walt was a legend here in town, and many of the many of the principles that we founded Jazz Outreach Initiative with, we learned from Walt. And you know how we proceed forward all came from mine and Kenny's being taught by Walt. Now the connection with NSA is that Walt was the trumpet teacher, but his wife, Carol Blanton, was actually director of NSA. And I tell you that to tell you for modern day. So what we have today is we are announcing that moving forward from today, every year, we are going to have an award for the outstanding senior that is in the Las Vegas Youth Jazz Orchestra. It will be called the Walter J. Blanton Award for Musical Excellence. And like I said, I have some notes here. So the Walter J. Blanton Award for Musical Excellence is presented to a graduating senior in the Las Vegas Youth Jazz Organization who displays dedication to and personal development within the music program. Outstanding Musicianship Award is awarded to one student from the program, Music Disciplines, who demonstrates a high level of musicianship and dedication to the music program. The student who receives the Walter J. Blanton Award for Musical Excellence must meet all the following criteria. Participation in the program for at least one full school year demonstrates consistent positive leadership in all ensembles, consistently strives for excellence in their own musicianship, consistent attendance and participation in the program, and honors their classmates and teachers. Along with an award and recognition, the student will receive $1,000 to further their musical education. This award will be presented at the Las Vegas Youth Jazz Orchestra Spring Concert annually. So to talk more about this award and to speak on this and to actually speak about Walt, I would ask Carol Blanton to come to the stage. Carol Blanton.
Gary, all of this time that it's been for joy, which is terrific. I have myriad notes too, but I don't know what they say anymore.
They all, when I mention Walt's name, they all went out the
window. Yeah. Oh, we have, I've known Kenny and Gary since they were in their late teens, which was wonderful at the Nevada School of the Arts, and I was assistant director at that time.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's been a long, great, fun time. And so I was wandering around the house and I was thinking, what am I going to say? I thought, well, I know, I'll just wander into Walt's studio and see if he has some inspiration for me this morning. So I looked and I saw all of the mementos, you know, from all the years, from all the students, all the photos. And you think about how many generations have passed through Walt and my lives. It's just been wonderful. All the music is such a wonderful thing to have all the support. And so I was thinking, how could we transcend that from Walt at this time? So I was looking, and there was his last composition, unfinished, of course, on his desk. And the title of it was The Call. That's what we've been called to do. Just be here, be together. Yes, explore this absolutely wonderful field of music together, but to have so much fun and enjoy each other so much. There's such a camaraderie between parents, supporters, all the students, the teachers, everyone who's made this a very successful and wonderful program. So are we ready?
Absolutely.
So at this time, if I can sort of be a normal person, we're going to present this wonderful award for the very first time, and it will be done every year in perpetuity. And I'm going to present this to Ben Bernstein.
Thank you so much. I can't think of another student that's deserving like Ben. Ben has always had a history of musical excellence and stepping up, and he will be continuing his education. I don't think he's made up his mind yet. He has had many offers to go where, but I'm sure wherever he goes, he'll be wonderful. So thank you, Ben. Ben Bernstein. So speaking of Ben Bernstein, we are going to play a Charles Mingus tune now that is going to feature Ben Bernstein. This is a very exciting tune called Boogie Stop Shuffle. Thank you. And alto saxophone, Dave Pomada. On piano, Kristen Lebrunner. On drums, Max Solomon. And on bass, Benjamin Bernstein. So just as a note, I think that's the fastest we've ever taken.
Right.
That was exciting. That was almost like meanness. You know, it goes back to what I was saying earlier. It's watching these students as they evolve. When we first played that tune, here's the tempo we played it. That's how we started. And to watch them evolve and get excited about the music and get it up to tempo is just, it's something magical as the year goes on. Very proud of all the students for that. So we don't get to this point without a lot of help. And if you will indulge me, I would like to thank a lot of people because this doesn't happen on its own. First, this program would not be where it is without our mentors. And I would love the mentors help me on a weekly basis. They help run the section. Some of them run these tunes, and they fill in my absence. And I would like to recognize our mentors, even if they're not here. Our mentor, Eddie Rachel, saxophones. Mentor John Summers, he's in the audience. I saw him. He's here. Not only is he our president now, he also set up all the sound for today, and he's videotaping, and he is also a mentor for our trombones, Mr. Kurt Miller. Also helping out on trombones, he's a legend here in town, Mr. Sonny Hernandez. Rachel Eckroff on piano. And we did have, when we started the semester, we actually did have string players. And unfortunately, our violinist had to drop out, but she's there every week helping. And I would like to recognize Lauren Cordell on the violin. I want to thank the Joy Board of Directors for making this all happen. Katie Rampton, he's our founder and artistic director. You guests, please clap for him. You met Kurt Miller, our president. Dr. Linda Woodson, who is our vice president. Julianne McCray, who is our secretary. Dan Phillips, who is our treasurer. And you met our executive director earlier, Mr. Johnny Thompson. So now I would like to recognize these students who have put in so much hard work this semester. It's unbelievable how far we've come. You think about this program that we're playing today. Every one of these charts that we're playing, these are not the student versions that you get. These are the professional charts. And I would like to recognize each one of these students and have them stand. On tenor saxophone and soprano saxophone, Samir Arya. On alto saxophone, Joshua Alvalo. Alto saxophone, Paul Beard. Alto saxophone, Andrew Fulmer. Alto saxophone, Matthew Pomani. Tenor saxophone, Gino Morrow. And anchoring in our section down on the end, Mr. Ryan Hill, Mary Saxophone. And trombone, Matt Ellis. And trombone, Noah Kosinski. And on trombone, Sam Fulmer. I'm super proud of all these kids, but last year, if you would have told me that Sam Fulmer would have stood up and took a solo, I'd never would have believed. Sam stood up and took a solo today. So very proud of Sam.
Yeah.
Our trumpets right here on the end, Gianna Christensen. Trumpet, Nathan DeLulo. And on trumpet, Silas Beardy. On piano, we have Christian McGarvey. Just so you know, although we don't call upon him to do it, because we desperately needed a piano player, Christian is also a very talented saxophonist. On bass, Ben Bernstein. So if you go to the fall concert, know that I told you in our first year back from COVID, I struggled to find a drummer. And so I prayed for drummers and over and over and asked anybody and everybody to send me drummers. And somebody was listening because I ended up with four very talented drummers. And I want you to meet each and every one of them. Sitting behind the kid right now, Jonathan Machado. Behind him, Max Hall. Next to him is Elijah Ramirez. And next to him is Clark Anderson. Special note, it's very satisfying for me to see Clark in this group because some of my very first professional gigs, I actually played with his grandfather, the great Tommy Check, on drums. So, good to see Clark. And the last group of people that I want to thank, and as you can see in the program, is that I want to thank each and every one of the members of the family, of these students' families and parents. You know, it's a big ask to come out on a Sunday afternoon for 3.5 hours. And, you know, parents do it all. You guys, you're chauffeurs and you're everything. And I see you bringing your kids and, you know, I see you dropping your kids off. And you know, at these concerts is when I actually get the opportunity to thank you for everything that you do to make it possible for these students. So, on behalf of myself, I would like to thank every one of the parents in this room. Thank you very much. So we have come to the last tune of the day. And I have saved one of the best arrangements for last. Earlier this year, we lost one of the true jazz icons, Wayne Shorter. And so at the beginning of the semester, I didn't have this tune programmed. But because of Wayne and who he is and what he meant to music, I felt it was important to program this and have the students learn this piece. This is an arrangement that Kenny helped procure for us from Jazz at Lincoln Center's Marcus Printup. And this is Armageddon.
Thank you.
Tamir Arlo on the saxophone, Leah Kosinski on trombone. And I need to tell you one more thing. We have a young man here that is just starting his jazz journey, and he has been coming to every rehearsal on Sundays. He is being mentored by our mentor, Rachel Eckroff, and the hope is that he will eventually take over the piano chair next year for us. I want you to meet and recognize Vincenzo Piazza. And he's like the Las Vegas Youth Jazz Orchestra. Thank you very, very much. That's a wonderful opportunity.